in the wake of what may prove to be the worst oil spill in our nation's history. We're talking with the lead attorney in the class action suit that will be filed, my friend and co-host, Mike Papantonio. Mike, before the break, we talked about what has been going on in terms of the response, and the industry response classically is misdirection. You mentioned your own local newspaper, and I was reading that one of the things they're pointing to is how the BP's offer of $25 million seems like a generous beginning to help with the cleanup. Isn't this part of that misdirection effort?
Well, of course it is. I mean, here, look, the flying monkeys that are sent out by the industry come in different forms. One is the guy who used to be a PR guy, who used to work for a newspaper, and now he's a PR guy, and he calls the newspaper and says, golly, you know, y'all are really being hard on us. Let's have lunch. And then they have their well-focused talking points. And unfortunately, a newspaper, I mean, look, we have a good newspaper here. It's a Gannett. It's a good newspaper. I mean, I like these people. They're my friends. But what happens is, even with their level of sophistication, They miss the idea that they're getting hustled. And this is a very sophisticated bunch, but they're getting hustled.
It's a shell game.
Well, of course it's a shell game. In this situation, it's a BP game, and it all fits together. But look, this is a company that they have a hard time saying that we're a good public citizen. Prudhoe Bay, 6,000 barrels spilled into Prudhoe Bay, at the end of it, they have to admit that it only happened because they cut corners on safety. The refinery explosion killed 15 people, injured 170 in Texas. At the end of it, they have to plead to felonies. Sorry, we cut corners. We cut down on our safety overwatch. And it's not, I'm sorry, they're saving money. Look, these CEOs are on what we call a short-time max profit plan. Used to be a CEO would come in with a company, and they'd say, I'm going to be here for a long time. I'm going to be here 25 years. Mm-hmm. So there was no immediate gratification. It was more about sustainability of the company. Now you have a guy like Settles or any of these people that come into a corporation, and they're moving through like overnight because all they're really trying to do is maximize their bonuses.
It's like sharks. It's keep moving or die.
Correct. So they're not there for 25 years. And so it's easy for them to say, I'm not really as much concerned about the sustainable reputation of this company as I am, how much can I maximize the next quarter?
And wasn't this the same thing that sank Detroit? Same mindset,
oh,
right?
Absolutely. Absolutely. So, but the point is we have this mentality that has been around now for 25 years. The pharmaceutical industry, the auto industry, you name it, it is the new way of thinking. And this is part of it. Maximize profits, cut, even if it means that we're going to destroy an entire culture, an entire ecosystem. We're going to kill people in the process. We're going to destroy people's lives. Doesn't make any difference because it's a corporation. It's not a person. Now, let me make a proposal to you. The proposal is this. In 1890, in the United States, there came onto the books a law that says that what we can do is we can invoke what they call the corporate death penalty, state by state. It depends on which states adopted it, but Michigan adopted it, New York adopted it, Ohio, several other states. As a matter of fact, they've used it. They've said that sometimes a corporation is so incorrigible, they're just so, it's so risky for them to do business, they have such an ugly, jaded, checkered record that
you can kill it?
You can kill it, yes. You can
really
put it to death by saying you may not do business in our state. Now, they can do business somewhere else, but you can't do it in our state, off our coast. You can't do it in our borders. So that's something that's a very real thing.
Mike, does the corporation have to be chartered in that state, or can be any corporation business in the state?
A lot of iterations of that. But just let me assure you, it can be accomplished. And if somebody gets mad enough, they'll see fit to do exactly that. And it'll be more of it'll be an important message, one that is a meaningful message.
Well, talk about citizen empowerment. This is what the Tea Partiers, if they were intellectually honest, and that's a stretch.
Where are the Tea Partiers?
Yeah, where's the outrage about this? But if in fact, this anti-corporate, anti-huge, big influence over people's lives, which is what BP has just done, BP, more than any government action, BP has just affected, as you said, the livelihood, perhaps the permanent livelihood of hundreds of thousands of people, maybe millions. And if there was genuine outrage, then what would happen is these very corporate requirements, the corporate death penalty, could be brought into play in places like Louisiana, Alabama, Mississippi. Where is the popular will for that, do you think?
First of all, people have to get over their sense of being charmed into believing that it's not as bad as it actually is. It's disastrous. And then they have to understand that I see this all the time. I see it. It's almost a suspension of disbelief. And it is, I appear in front of juries and you say to the jury, you know, this corporation did this, 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 and this. And they hear them and it's conduct that's akin to murder. It's conduct that is akin sometimes to genocide. And they say in their minds, I can't believe that actually happens. And there's this denial that it happens. There's this notion that surely corporate America doesn't act like that. But the truth is it does. But how many of us really have any sense of that? Because how many of us do what I do? In what Bobby Kennedy does.
Well, that's right. And it's the scale of it, Mike. It's the sheer scale, because when you give people something to look at that they can relate to in their own lives, and classically that was Bill Clinton having, you know, sex in the Oval Office, that people can understand because they've all known someone who's cheated on their husband or wife. But when you talk about George Bush illegally taking the country to war, causing thousands, if not tens of thousands of lives in the Middle East, it's so beyond comprehension. It is a scale that people can't relate to. Mike, let's take a quick break. We're talking with Mike Papantonio about the BP oil spill in the Gulf. I'm David Bender. This is Ring of Fire. Stay with us. We'll be right back.